Hello, my name is Ben Ricks. I'm the District 2 Fisheries Biologist with the North Carolina Wildlife Resource Commission. Thank you for the opportunity to speak with you about the Neuse River striped bass population. This is an important fishery along the central coast of North Carolina. The Neuse River striped bass population is different from a recovered striped bass population. I will outline what makes the Neuse River striped bass population different, along with some basic striped bass biology, the striped bass stocking program, some of the limitations to recovery efforts, and some common misconceptions. First, let's cover a few striped bass facts. Striped bass naturally occur from Canada to Texas. Striped bass are anadromous, which means they spawn in fresh water and live their juvenile and adult lives in the estuaries and in the Atlantic Ocean. Striped bass can potentially live over 20 years and weigh over 50 pounds. On the Neuse River, however, most striped bass are between ages 2 and 6 and range from 2 to 8 pounds. Historically, striped bass were in all North Carolina's coastal rivers. Currently, there's only one population of striped bass in North Carolina that is sustained by natural reproduction, the Albemarle Roanoke stock. The Tar River, the Neuse River, and the Cape Fear River striped bass populations are all hatchery supported. Many of North Carolina's reservoirs are also stocked with striped bass. The Neuse River is supported by hatchery-raised striped bass. Striped bass are collected from the Neuse River between Goldsboro and Raleigh each spring. These fish are then spawned at the Edenton National Fish Hatchery. We have an annual production goal of 100,000 phase 2 or 6 to 8 inch striped bass fingerlings. The results of our hatchery evaluations have shown that nearly 80% of the striped bass in the Neuse River are stocked fish. This percentage will likely increase in the future. The hatchery contribution is certainly a conservation concern because it means that very few wild spawned striped bass are in our surveys, if any. We often get asked why there are no big fish in the Neuse River. To put it simply, it takes time to grow big fish. For instance, the average size of a 5-year-old fish is 24 inches, while a 40-inch striped bass is at least 10 years old at the very youngest. In the Neuse River, very few striped bass live over 8 years old, and therefore we see very few fish over 30 inches. This is a result of the high mortality rates, or the percentage of fish that die off each year. Mortality occurs naturally, as in disease, but also can occur from both recreational and commercial fishing effort. When mortality from fishing pressure is too high, fish often cannot live as long as they would normally. To reduce mortality, regulations are needed in inland, joint, and coastal waters that would limit excessive fishing effort on this population. Examples of these reductions might look like increased size limits, shortened seasons, and decreased harvest. Why can't striped bass naturally reproduce in the Neuse River? In short, they do. Spawning activity has been observed. Females that have released all or most of their eggs have been collected every year. In an egg study, we collected fertilized and developing striped bass eggs drifting down the Neuse River, as well as larvae. All of this evidence is evidence that spawning is occurring. However, the amount of eggs being produced is insufficient. It has been documented in recovered striped bass populations that the larger, older female striped bass contribute more to a year's production than younger, smaller females. The low number of larger, older females in the Neuse River population is resulting in low egg production, and therefore wild fish are rare in the Neuse River. The striped bass in the Neuse River are going through the motions, but their efforts aren't resulting in young striped bass entering the population. We often are asked if flow or water quality are issues for the Neuse River striped bass population. While these issues could have influence on Neuse River striped bass, it's not likely that they are major driving factors. Water velocity or speed in the Neuse River is not unlike rivers with recovered striped bass populations. Neuse River striped bass grow very rapidly compared to nearby rivers. If they were stressed from poor water quality, growth rates would likely be decreased. While these are important issues to understand, they are likely not limiting factors in the Neuse River as much as the mortality rates are. The current reality is that we have a put, grow, and take fishery in the Neuse River, where fish are stocked, caught, and more fish are stocked again. Until the high mortality rates can be resolved, conservation gains are not likely. Angling opportunities are good right now, but they could be even better. As long as stocking efforts continue, the population and striped bass angling opportunities will remain stable at current levels, but recovery will not occur. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or would like to like more information about the Neuse River striped bass or any other fisheries issues in District 2, please feel free to contact me.